interesting conversations this week. And what these conversations did was solidify something that I have long known to be true. And that is that many women actually are loyal. They are incredibly loyal to the men that they love, for better or for worse. Now, unfortunately, many times it ends up being for worse. What I've noticed, and I will say, this isn't just something I've noticed among Black women, this is something that I have noticed among all women. There have been so many different times where I'm talking to a woman and she may be explaining a new guy that she met or someone she's dating, and man, she's painting this picture like this dude is sent from heaven. I mean, it is the most beautiful Disneyfication. He understands my needs, he's this, he's that, you know what I mean? He looks at me and he just knows what I'm thinking. It's just this great, beautiful picture. And then generally what happens is they break up and then I get more of the full picture. And either it's, you know, they break up and he's the problem, or they break up and it's like, oh, by the way, he was an alcoholic. Oh yeah, by the way, he also was a drug addict. Oh, by the way, he also beat me. Oh, by the way. And I'm like, wait, huh? How am I? Those were actually important details that you just somehow decided to completely like not share, or just decided to not mention. And this has happened so many times, more often than not. And I started to recognize this theme. I started to recognize, you know, what is that saying? Like rose colored glasses. And I'm like, this is actually a real thing. Like when a woman is emotionally involved with a man, this man has her heart, whatever it may be, then it's like he can do no wrong. And of course, this is not for everybody. You know, I think if a woman, maybe she comes from a really stable background, has strong relationships, has strong accountability, maybe has a strong relationship with her dad or brothers or uncles or whatever it may be, then, you know, she may have dudes who can kind of put her up on game and be like, hey, like, this is this, this is that. I think that's really helpful. But there's many women out there who don't have that. They didn't maybe have healthy interactions with guys or have brothers or have friends or, you know, just people in their life that could share another perspective. So they're like fresh prey. And, you know, this is why I think people like AMS, like, this is why people like him can exist. Because I think honestly, this is one of the weaknesses of women, that you get her heart, you get her emotionally, and it's like, it's game over. It is game over. And like I said, I think this can be a beautiful quality. You know, if you get a loving woman and she's loyal and supportive, but it can also be really detrimental if this woman ends up choosing guys who will take advantage of her. And I think more often than not, this ends up being the case. And again, I'm telling you, this is just my anecdotal experience, but the amount of women that I have spoken with who have chosen time and time again, bad actors. I mean, bad actors. And then they walk away and they say, oh man, these men out here, these men are this, 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 and that. And I have to be like, no, it's not all men, it's the men you're choosing. Why are you choosing a drug addict? Like, are you freaking going to the homeless shelter and picking these guys? Or are you like going off the street and just finding bumps? Like, what are you doing? And I'm like, and you talk to him and it's like, oh, well, you know, I like the way he smiled, or his eyes were this, or he just said I was beautiful. And it's like, they're explaining this stuff and it's super sentimental. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this is... So of course, I'm not saying this is all women. Like, I think maybe older women or women who just are a little more mature have just no more than they can kind of avoid some of these things, but it is a very real thing. And I think I wish I could say this was just for young women, but it's not necessarily. I've noticed this among all ages range. I mean, among women as, you know, young as 18, 17, up to women into their 40s. And I'm just like, wow, this is really serious. And so I think knowing that sometimes us women, I don't know if it's because we can be emotional sometimes, knowing that this is something that we can be susceptible to, I think one of the best things, one of the best ways to actually guard yourselves from choosing guys or just being in situations where you're going to be taken advantage of, and then now you think all men are like that, I think one, it's incredibly important to have healthy community to have healthy accountability. I cannot reinforce that enough. You know, when I was dating my husband, I had already established a relationship with people in my life that I felt like were spiritual authorities. I had safe friendships, you know, that people that I felt like, okay, you're going to tell me the truth. You're going to tell me, for better or for worse, if I'm missing something. And so, I mean, honestly, that saved me so much, because there were situations previously where I had brought in guys or brought in people, and I had some of these friends be like, I don't know, you know what I mean? And I wasn't necessarily feeling it, but I was happy that they're, you know, willing to tell me the truth. And so I can't say enough about having accountability, about having that community. Ideally, you know, you would get that in your family. You would get that with, you know, your father, your mother, aunts and uncles, you know, extended family. But for those of you who don't, I think it's still important to seek that out. Seek out, you know, spirit-filled, godly people, people who have good practical insight, who can tell you the real truth. And I'm not talking about, you know, some quote unquote spiritual leaders out there who just want you to pay them tithes, because unfortunately there are those out there too. I'm talking about real people who actually have your best interest in heart and who will tell you the truth no matter what. Like I said, that could be a brother, that could be a dad, an uncle, it could be somebody at your church that you respect, or just somebody in the family. But just seeking out those real people makes all of the difference. And then secondly, I always say, I said this again, it's like I always would like to hang around people who had the results that I wanted. So for example, like when I wanted to be married, I would start, you know, hanging around married friends. And so I would say, as a single woman, you probably do not need to be taking advice from other single women. Like, that seems like it would be common sense, but for many it's not. Like, I would recommend do not take advice from single women. It's going to be a lot better to take advice from married women, especially those who have been through some seasons, who've been married maybe a couple of decades, who have maybe grown children. Like, I think that's ideal. Being around those people and having them, you know, tell you the truth and really, for lack of a better term, vet through those different processes, I think can really help eliminate a lot, because you have a lot of young girls going on today fending for themselves, maybe not coming from families, maybe not coming from a strong background. They are literally fending for themselves and they have their blinders on, and it creates total chaos. And I really believe this is one main reason that women, when they're young, they make these decisions because they don't have accountability, because they don't have a family, they don't have a good structure, they don't know what to look for. And then by the time they're 30 or 40, whatever it may be, they've been ran through so often, they think all men are trash. And it's like, no, it's not that all men are trash, it's just what you are picking. And I have noticed this. I have noticed this as a woman who has talked to many women. I've noticed this time and time again, where women will romanticize the men that they love, even if these men are just downright evil or just downright vindictive. And I think that's a weakness that some of us women have, and it's just something that we have to be mindful of. So those are just my thoughts, but let me know what you think. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Let me know. I'd love to hear from you. Leave your questions, comments, concerns in the comment section below. Thank you so much for listening if you've gotten this far, and we'll talk later. Bye.